Hello everyone and welcome to the only Bukkit server tutorial you're going to need for Minecraft 1.3.1, and it should apply to most versions after that also, but I am very excited because I have solved your batch file problems by making an archive with four different batch files that you're just going to run each one until your server runs correctly, and then you can delete the other ones. This should take care of any problems of not knowing your path, etc. And then also at the end of the video, I have a really cool, easy way with a program to get your friends onto your server so that you can play together. All right, so let's get started. Open up your web browser and go to bukkit.org. Click on recommended build right there, and this is for version 1.3.1 and release 1.0, so make sure that that's the one you're getting. And if you're doing this in the future and it's a different version, this will all still work, the processes the same. So download that. And now the next step, if you don't have Java, or even if you do, do this for me because this is going to make it easier. Go to java.com, go to downloads, click on See All Java Downloads, and download the Windows Offline 32-bit version. It doesn't matter if you're on Windows 64-bit or 32-bit, this will work for you, and it'll just make our batch file issues a little bit better. All right, so download and install Java. Then go to minecraft.net, click on Download, and download the Minecraft Server EXE. And also, you're going to make sure you run your Minecraft game, you know, shortcut file, and update that so that it's also running 1.3.1. Okay, so now that we have downloaded craftbukkit and Minecraft server, you're also going to use the link in the description to download this John of All Games batch files rare archive. So first just open that with whatever program you have installed to open it. I use WinRare. Drag those over to your server folder that you've created and named whatever you want. You'll have run 1 through 4. Okay, so now put your craft bucket in there, but first you're gonna wanna rename it and remove the dash 1.3.1-R1.0. And the reason I did that is if you're watching this in the future and the version of Minecraft has changed, the batch files will still be the same because you've just named this craft bucket only. Okay, so put that in there, put your Minecraft server exe in there, and then click one of the run batch files and see which one works for you. I'll run one first that I know doesn't work for me. See, the system cannot find the path specified. That's because I know that one's using Java 6 and I don't have that installed. Now I'll run a different one and you can see that it is running. Starting Minecraft server version 1.3.1. It will prepare spawn area for the world. You're going to see some errors in here. That's because it's creating all of these files here. So let it run. It'll prepare a few spawn areas. When it says done, type stop, wait for it. It says saving chunks, might take a minute. Press any key to continue, that'll close that window out. Then you can run your server again and it'll be good. But first, delete the other batch files that didn't work for you. So now you just have the one you need. And you can name that whatever you want, or just leave it like that. So run that again. And now your server is up and running normal. So that is excellent. Okay, now for the second usually difficult part for people is how to get my friends onto my server. So for that, we have a very handy solution for you. Go to evolvehq.com. It is an application that you install, but it does the tunnel through the internet so that your LAN can join, your friends can join your LAN, and it makes this virtual, you know, LAN through the internet. But it also does a lot of other stuff. You can do VoIP, which is voice over IP, you know, kind of like Skype. It does screenshots, and it does screen recording, which I haven't played with much, but I guess it works pretty well. It tracks stats. It just does a lot of things. It's really cool. So you should go there, register, download that. And then, so you say you have your server running here. You get Evolve installed. Let me open that up. First thing you want to do, you get it running, go to File, Preferences, go to Features, and some of these won't be checked. You have to check them to install them. It'll download something, install it. One lets you do the voice. One allows you to record video and screenshots. Another one is the party system. You need those installed, you know, just install them all, okay? So then what you do is there is a friend browser here. You can add, you know, get your friend's name, add them, And then you have your server running, remember? Okay, go to host game. You could do whatever you want, make it private if you want. And that just means that then you need to invite a friend. See? So here it is. I am the leader. If I hit X on this, it will close it, and your friends, I don't believe, will be able to access your server. But it still shows it. See, I'll close that. Multiple checking, close the tabs. Okay. See, it still shows it here as an active party. I can right-click and close that party out. But if you like that, you're going to use it a lot, just leave that there. You double-click it. I'm entering it. See, now it's connected. Okay. So you need to have that open so your friends can actually be on. So say you're going to quit playing and your friends are going to keep playing, and you leave your computer on, the server up, you need to leave this window open is basically what I'm getting at. And your friends will take this number that's under your name right there. It's like a special number that Evolve created. It's not even your WAN IP that is, you know, the network that the world, or the IP that the world sees. It's like a different one for Evolve. If they just take that, and we will open up Minecraft here. Let's see, that is, we'll just type it in here so I can copy it. 10.216.231.2. They'll just take that. Here, let's log in. Multiplayer. And we will do add server. You can name that whatever you want. They'll put that right in there. And then they'll be able to see it. And it'll show that they're connected. As for you being the host, you can do that too. So that you can just join it. Or you can type localhost every time. That just means that it's hosted on the same computer you're running Minecraft on. That's all that means. And there's your new world. Again, if there's water all around, you think your whole world's water. It's not. It's just your spawn is in water, which is unfortunate. And what you'd want to do is stop your server. Get all these out of the way. If that happens, what you'd want to do is just, you could just delete everything basically, or I think you should just be able to delete these three world files. Delete those, and then next time you run it, it'll recreate a new world. Hello. There we go. See, it's preparing it. It's like making a completely new world, so that'll solve that. Okay, so thanks so much for watching. I hope this helped you out a ton. And I hope you just are so happy you found my video. Happy enough to hit like and add to favorites, because that really helps it rank well in search results, and I will be forever grateful. I'm also going to put some annotations here at the end to some other popular tutorials of mine, like how to find diamonds quick, and maybe just a few other server type fact answering. I'm not sure. I'll put a few things up here. Also, I just want to mention that I make these tutorials because, well, I like to help you, but it also brings in a lot of new people that are searching for this type of stuff to see my other content, because I am playing games and uploading footage and trying to do a lot of that kind of stuff. So you should check out my other content, because I would really appreciate it. And also, I'm going to be doing giveaways, and right now I'm giving away Skyrim, so you can click on this annotation right here to check that out. I'm going to be ending that one really soon, actually. But if that one's not active, just look through my channel. I might have a playlist by then with the other giveaways that I'll be doing. So yeah, thanks a lot for watching. It really is cool to hear from you guys, so you should comment and let me know how it worked. And sorry if this doesn't sound scripted, because it's not, and I'm making it up as I go. But thank you for watching. Goodbye.